Thank you, madam.
This is your first appearance ever on British television, is it?
Yes.
We're very happy to have you here.
Anton, I'm very glad to be here.
Well, you are very much of an institution, very, very well known indeed, very famous in Germany. I know you've won two of the top awards, or twice you've won the top award. So you must be very much recognized on the street wherever you go in Germany.
In Germany, yes, yes. Here, no. And absolutely
that,
not.
You say that yes. With a great sense of relief. Are you very pleased to get away from it all?
I don't understand.
To have a little rest from people recognizing you on
yes.
the street.
Yes, in Germany.
But do they keep you very busy when they recognize you on the street?
I can't understand. That's,
do you have to sign
Yes.
Autographs?
That's, sometimes it's terrible, yes, but it's nice sometimes to make funny things with the people and write things and little drawings making. But sometimes when you would like to eat something or to go in the station and you are in a hurry, and so then it's most terrible. But it's good, for example, never happen that I couldn't get a room in a hotel or so, or tickets for a concert. That's always...
That's very useful.
That's very useful,
but
yes.
But it's just
yes,
a little
yes.
relief to get away
yes,
from it.
Sure,
can
yes,
you tell
yes.
me how you started as a comedian? Did you, in fact, start life...
As a comedian? That was in 1968.
And what did you do yes. before that?
I was a cartoonist. I was making drawings. More or less funny drawings.
And so that you were always, as it were, in the humour business. Do you think that your humour has arisen from your experience of human nature and your observation of human nature as a cartoonist, that this has affected...
Yes, and especially for the German nature.
Could you sure. describe to us what you think German humour is and how it differs from British humour, say?
I think it's, from a terrible English, it's absolutely difficult to explain it, but German people is generally a little bit serious, and they are speaking official language, and that together, the official language of the German people and absolutely stupid things which they are doing, that together could be terrible funny.
Because it's ridiculous, you mean, to talk officially when you're
yes.
doing something very ordinary.
Yes, it's ridiculous.
And people use this language, do they, in everyday life, or is it just on official occasions?
I think there's a difference between the German people and the English people. The English language is there are not so differences. It's just, you can speak in any case the same language. And the Germans, I think, when they are speaking with the chief or to official people, then they have another style of speaking.
And this appeals to your sense of humor. Does this give you a sense of the ridiculous?
Yes.
In fact, the human nature in its most ridiculous form tried to be pompous.
Sure.
But we have a lot of that, you know, in England as well. Yes. I mean, the pompous mm-hmm. the pompous man mm-hmm. who drops his trousers and looks ridiculous mm-hmm. or yes. Very much like the kind of thing that you're doing, trying mm-hmm. to do an official thing mm-hmm. like coming through a security barrier. Mm-hmm. And that, mm-hmm. Of course, is totally universal humor. I mean, as you can hear, everybody here absolutely fell about mm-hmm. at that. But all your humour is not like that. Does your humour travel well? How do you think? Do you think you would have to adapt what you do if we were going to see it outside Germany?
When I understood you in the right way now, I think when I go through London, for example, or so, sure, a lot of funny things happen. But I think when I would live here, I would do things in another way.
Where do you get your material? I mean, do you observe situations and draw characters? Would you describe yourself as a character
funny,
comedian?
It's a funny thing, but I think never I'm really observing. But always in my life, in any second, I'm sensitive for that what's happening. And so when I'm sitting at home and make a drawing or write a sketch or so, then all the things I saw will come up.
Do you impersonate people? Is that part of what you do?
Yes.
But you're not
yes.
an impersonator as such?
No.
That is just a byproduct?
Yes.
And you draw many characters from life?
Yes. I like it to do so if I would be another person.
And you prefer to hide. Do you find that rather than playing yourself, that you are in fact happier in a character?
Yes, in my program, I'm only a little part. I'm myself. All the other things, then I need some little things to change.